Hi, and welcome to the Mayor's Report. I'm Mayor David J. Narkowitz of the City of Northampton, and this is my monthly television program on Northampton Community Television, where we discuss some of the issues and projects that we're working on in the City of Northampton. As you've probably heard, there's been a lot of talk in the state around transportation. It's been a major issue that the governor has been talking about, the legislature, as well as it's an issue we talk about here in Northampton at the local level. So I thought it would be an important discussion to talk about here on the Mayor's Report. So today we have as a special guest Massachusetts Department of Transportation Aeronautics Administrator Chris Willenborg, who's going to talk to us about the governor's Way Forward proposal on transportation, as well as other transportation issues affecting the state, as well as the City of Northampton. So Chris, welcome to Northampton and welcome to the Mayor's Report.
Great. Thank you, Mayor Narkowitz. Glad to be on your show today and look forward to sharing with you the great work that we're doing at MassDOT and share with you the governor's plan.
Okay, great. Well, why don't we start right there? I know that one part of what the governor and what Secretary Davey were working on is first going out around the Commonwealth and really trying to listen to people about transportation needs. I know we had hearings in Amherst and in Springfield. I tried to let our constituents know about the one that happened over at UMass. Can you tell me a little bit about those public hearings that were held around the state?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, it was very important that the governor and Secretary Davey wanted to be sure that we heard from our customers what they wanted to see their future transportation system to look like. So we went across the state, 17 or 18 different locations, and we were in Amherst and Springfield. I actually attended the public meeting out at Amherst. And what we heard, and there were some common themes that we heard around the state, but particularly in Amherst, we heard about the regional equity in regards to transportation needs. RTA services, improved service, extended hours. Also funding, Chapter 90. We heard from many municipal leaders on the importance of Chapter 90 funding. And also improvement on our bike and pedestrian efforts, rail trails and things like that. So the message was pretty clear that we need to invest into our transportation system, and we heard that statewide.
And those are definitely issues of importance to Northampton. We've made a major focus on our transportation system, particularly providing alternative transportation systems. We have a nationally recognized bike trail network, and we've won awards for our focus on pedestrian improvements and trying to just make the city more livable, more walkable, more bikeable. And Chapter 90 is a big one for us because, like the state, like many other cities and towns, we have a pretty deep backlog of maintenance needs on our streets, our sidewalks, and at the level Chapter 90 has been funded, we really haven't been able to address as many of those needs as we'd like to. So the Way Forward was the governor's, what he called his 21st century transportation plan. And I know that I've been with Transportation Secretary Davey at a number of events, and I know that he has said that, the way the system's currently structured is really not sustainable, and it's not really going to allow us to move forward to really have the kind of first-class transportation system we want. So tell me a little bit about that plan that the governor has proposed.
Sure. So in this plan, it's a 10-year plan where we invest $1.3 billion. So it's a $13 billion program over 10 years, but invest $1.3 billion into our transportation infrastructure across the Commonwealth. And, it's critical. As you know, transportation plays an important role in every resident's life across the Commonwealth. And we want to be sure that every mode, which is a conduit for economic development, receives the funding necessary to preserve what we have, as well as enhance the system. So in the governor's plan, about 80% of that $13 billion is for state of good repair. So those are for existing transportation infrastructure. And we're reinvesting, doing the preventative maintenance, investing into that critical infrastructure. The remaining 20% are new initiatives that the governor is looking at. So for example, the South Coast Rail or the Green Line Extension or rail service from the Berkshires down to New York City. So that pretty much gives a real overview of what the plan calls for.
Now, we mentioned Chapter 90 earlier, and for folks at home, Chapter 90 is basically the We pay our gasoline tax, and there's a formula that then redistributes a portion of that funding back to cities and towns that we use to do our road projects and things like that. So I know people will want to know, it's great that there's this big plan, but how's it going to affect Northampton? What would it mean in terms of new funding for the city of Northampton?
Sure. In particular, I mean, the Chapter 90 funds, as you mentioned, for municipal government, the Chapter 90 program is critical for improvements on local roads. And in the governor's plan, it calls for an increase from $200 million to $300 million. So, for example, in Northampton, that would basically increase the Chapter 90 funds to approximately $510,000 for the city of Northampton, which they can then utilize on maintenance on the local roads. Hmm. But overall, you know, there are many bridge and roadway programs that projects that we're trying to address across the Commonwealth and along the I-91 corridor here. There are bridge projects that we're looking to do that we need to have the necessary funding in place. Once again, that whole transportation is a conduit for economic development, and we really need to invest into that infrastructure.
Mm-hmm. I know as a mayor, one of the things whenever I talk to our citizens about spending initiatives and about initiatives like that, I know one of the things that they're concerned about is, you know, how efficient are we being with their money? Are we doing the best we can to make sure that we're not duplicating efforts, that we're spending that money wisely? And I know sometimes in the area of transportation, you know, particularly out here in the western part of the state, you know, sometimes people think of the Big Dig, and it raises negative connotations. Now I know Secretary Davey, has been sort of on a singular mission to reform that agency. And I know I remember distinctly meeting with him as a new mayor, and he wore a pin, which he actually gave me, which says, you know, because that's the way we've always done it. And it kind of had a line through it,
yes,
sort of saying that, you know, just because we've always had two or three different, you know, agencies doing something, that doesn't mean it's the right way to do it. So talk about some of the reforms that have been underway. That I think can give people more trust in terms of these kinds of investments.
No, absolutely. I mean, since 2009, when transportation reform came into place, MassDOT has realized savings of $500 million, and where we've reinvested that money back into our infrastructure in state of good repair. But as you mentioned, Secretary Davey is very focused on reform. It's an ongoing process at MassDOT. We consistently have performance management measures. It's a big focus of Governor Patrick, but our agency, the operating divisions at MassDOT, so that's the Highway Division, RMV, Rail and Transit, and Aeronautics, we meet quarterly with the Secretary. We go through our performance measures. We have to answer to the Secretary and the senior leadership team if we're not meeting our benchmarks. The Secretary has also been very active in combining departments, particularly the enterprise services at MassDOT, and the MBTA. So for example, in the past, you had a separate law department at the MBTA and MassDOT. Those are now combined. HR, same thing, combined. Office of Civil Rights, IT. So we're really focusing in on reform within our house at DOT and moving that forward.
Mm-hmm.
So those are a couple examples.
Thank you for sure. That. Another thing that I think that's important, so particularly out here in the Pioneer Valley in Northampton, and you mentioned the term RTA, which is a regional transit authority, and out here it's the Pioneer Valley Transit Authority, or PVTA, and it's one of the larger RTAs in the Commonwealth. And, you know, being in an area that's not as densely urban as Boston, you know, people rely on a good public transportation system to get around, and so I know that I sit on the PVTA's advisory board. I represent Northampton and the Pioneer Valley on our advisory board, and one of the big issues with RTAs has been the funding structure, the fact that they essentially have to borrow their operating budgets every year. And so the big issue has been, you know, forward funding them. So having them, you know, having money appropriated for fiscal year 13, for fiscal year 13 operations, as opposed to, you know, funding FY13 operations, borrowing to do it, and then having it backfilled with an appropriation. I know that that requires an investment, but I know that it puts a lot of pressure on an RTA like PVTA And so talk a little bit about that. Is that part of the of what the governor's plan entails?
Yes, absolutely. And I think throughout this process, the governor and Secretary Davey have heard clearly from the RTA administrators that forward funding is an absolute must moving forward. And that is included in the governor's transportation plan. Mm-hmm. As you know, as we heard from our customers across the state, even in the Pioneer Valley region, whether it was Amherst or Springfield, the PVTA plays a critical role in moving people across this region. And in the governor's plan, we increased for operating assistance. Currently, they receive about $17 million a year. Under the governor's plan, that would increase between $40 and $50 million. Hmm. So we definitely, the governor and Secretary Davey realize the importance of the RTA's role they play, and forward funding is critical for that. It just does not make sense to do it the way we've always done it this way.
Exactly.
And that we definitely have to change that.
All right, well, that's good to hear. The other piece of this, which sometimes, you know, we talk about roads and bridges and buses, but the transportation system has an economic impact as well. It's the way we move people. It's the way we move goods and services. It's the way people get to and from jobs. I'm assuming that part of this plan also just talks about the economic impact and sort of multiplier effect of having a good transportation system in the state.
Yes, absolutely. I mentioned earlier, the transportation is key to economic development all across the Commonwealth. And obviously the governor's done an outstanding job reaching out across the Commonwealth to ensure jobs are being created. And in particular, in my area of expertise on aviation, 2 years ago we completed a statewide airport economic impact study. And what we found is at all the public use airports across the state, there are 39 of them, over 124,000 direct and indirect jobs with an economic output of nearly $12 billion can be attributed to aviation in our airports across the Commonwealth. Here locally, just your local airport here in Northampton, you can attribute about 25 direct and indirect jobs with an economic output of about $2 million. So transportation does play a critical role. You know, the example on the aviation side, you can see that it is key for growing our communities and providing a quality of life that all our residents deserve. Mm-hmm.
That's one of the reasons that we're excited about the, I know it's not part of this plan, but the Knowledge Corridor project, which is a project to restore rail up the Connecticut River corridor, which would bring rail back to Holyoke and Northampton and Greenfield. And I know that's underway, but one of the things I'm most interested in is just the fact that it's going to allow people to move up and down the valley, and I think will be an engine both for our tourism and our cultural assets here in the city, but also economic development. So so rail is another big one that we're very interested in. So I know aeronautics is your specialty, and I know you were saying you were just recently out at the airport. What's your take on Northampton Airport? I know the ownership there has been making a lot of investments in that facility, and how does your agency interact with a small airport like Northampton Airport?
Sure. So one of our responsibilities of the aeronautics division is to inspect our airports annually to make sure that they're safe for the public to use, as well as conduct investments into the facilities. So we work closely with Northampton Airport. They're considered a community business airport in our statewide system plan. And they play an important role in this region. Bob Bacon, who is the owner of the airport, and Rich McIsaac, who's the airport manager, have really done an outstanding job. And we're bringing the community to the airport to get a better understanding of the activities down there, particularly on the aviation education outreach side. They're very involved in what's called the Western Mass Right Flight Program, where they're going into the school systems and teaching them, getting kids involved about aviation. And if they meet certain criteria, it's all about goal setting. If they meet those goals, they actually fly an airplane with a certified flight instructor for about an hour.
Yeah, I know our local, the Northampton Education Foundation, which is a local nonprofit, I know that one of the grants they just renewed, they did it last year, it was wildly popular, was the Right Flight program.
Oh, that's
program.
Great.
Which again allows, you know, a middle school child to go through a whole education process that culminates in them actually flying a plane and landing a plane over Northampton. So that's it's pretty exciting, and obviously that's an asset that, you know, we drive by a lot.